Today, I'm going to share with you four simple ways to engage people in conversation with the gospel. I think this is going to be really helpful for you, so don't miss it. Hey guys, what's up? It's Isaac David, and this is the Daily Disciple, where I help you follow Jesus daily. Today, as I said, we're talking about evangelism. Disciples making disciples simply in conversation. I think we overcomplicate the gospel so much sometimes that we get overwhelmed and we feel like we're never equipped to share. I don't want you to feel that way, because look, that's not the truth. You can do it. So let's get into four simple ways that you can share the gospel in conversation. Way number one can be categorized as the good news, the bad news, and the good news. Really simply, within the context of university, let's say, I generally like to ask people, hey, do you know much about Christianity, as kind of an opener? Maybe we're talking about weather, maybe exchanging names and just getting to know each other. Hey, do you know much about Christianity? And then I'd like to sum up Christianity in the good news, the bad news, and the good news. The good news, we're all created in the image of God. Genesis 1:27, God created us in his image, right? And that means we all have intrinsic worth and value. I just lay that out for them and then say, yeah, but the bad news actually is that we've all sinned and rebelled against God. And because of that, there's a disconnection from us and God. We stand guilty before God because of our sin against God. And because of that, look, we deserve hell. But the good news is that Jesus, fully God and fully man, came to this earth to live a sinless life, a life we could not live, to die on the cross, a death we deserve to die for our sins against God. And he mended that relationship and made us right with God. And if we repent, which means, God, I'm sorry, saying, God, I'm sorry, and turning from our sin and putting our trust in Jesus, we can be saved. That's how I would lay it out for him. And I know that might sound overwhelming. Now you're like, oh, you touched on a lot of key pieces there. But remember our three kind of points, right? The good news, the bad news, and the good news. What happens in the good news? We're created in the image of God. What happens to the bad news? We've sinned and there's a disconnection from God. What's the good news? God has mended that relationship. And what is our response from that? It is repentance and faith. I found it so effective to ask people, hey, do you know about Christianity? I'm a Christian. Do you know much about it? Because it's interesting, because they're engaged in, like, you know, maybe they do know some stuff and they want to share it with you, and that can begin a conversation. I found that really effective in the university setting, so go ahead and use that. The second simple way to engage people in conversation with the gospel is sharing your testimony. Especially if it's people you already have a close relationship with, like family or close friends. Sharing your testimony can be a great gateway into sharing the hope of Jesus without feeling overbearing or preachy, because you're just sharing your story. I do this quite a bit, and especially at parties or at places where you're just getting to know people for the first time. If you're getting into your life story, ultimately, look, the gospel should be flowing out of that. So if somebody asks me what I do for a living or what my goals are, I talk about Daily Disciple Ministry, and I talk about the way that I am passionate about helping people follow Jesus, and that kind of leads into my testimony of Jesus. I think that's a great way of sharing the gospel, is just honing into what your testimony is. And look, your testimony is not boring. That is a lie from Satan to keep you quiet. You gotta share it, because it is a miracle. It is glorious. Share your testimony. That's a great way, simple way, of sharing the gospel in the midst of conversation, is just sharing what God has done in your own life. Way number three is what I like to call the judge analogy. This was kind of popularized by Ray Comfort, I feel like. Let me lay it out for you here, the judge analogy. Generally, I would use this if people are confused about, like, why would humans deserve hell, and why would that make sense? The judge analogy is great, because it really shows what is actually happening in our relationship with God. You see, we've all sinned, we've broken God's law, and you use that as an analogy. So you say, okay, a criminal has come in, he's broken a bunch of different laws, and he says to the judge, hey judge, I'm sorry, but I'll try to do better in my life, I'll try to be a good person. The judge says, okay, but I can't dismiss your case, you've committed a crime. And you ask the person, hey, do you think the judge should just let them go because they want to do better in their life? Well, they say, of course not. No, you gotta pay, you know, do the time if you do the crime, right? And that's the same thing in our relationship with God. God just can't let us go because we're saying we're going to try to be better people. But the amazing thing is we're bound, that person that committed those crimes is bound for punishment. But the judge steps down, takes off his robe and says, I will take your penalty for you. I will take your punishment, your sentence for you on myself. And that's what Jesus did for us. It's a powerful analogy because it brings what's going on in kind of the eternal sense, our relationship, the transcendent sense with our relationship with God into our earthly understanding of justice. Because if God is just, he has to punish sin. But it shows the amazing grace of God stepping off his judgment seat to be merciful to us, to take our punishment on himself. The last idea is called the bridge analogy, probably one of the most popular ways of sharing the gospel. And I like to do kind of a variation on this because look, none of these are black and white, like you have to do it and say exactly these things, right? These are all just kind of tools in your toolbox to help you share, right? So the bridge analogy is, you know, you're standing on the edge of a cliff, right? And what is separating you from the other side, from God, it is sin. Sin is that valley, right? We can't do anything to get across that kind of cavern to God, right? Our sin has separated us from him, but Jesus has made a way, and that's the cross coming down, forming the bridge, forming that way that we can be saved, to make it to the other side, to make it to eternal life, to new life. Now, as you're thinking about these different analogies and strategies and all that, I know it can be tempting to want to fall into one and do it like strictly word for word. Like I know when I was watching Ray Comfort, and maybe you've seen his videos, and I encourage you to watch his videos, evangelism videos. You can get in the habit of, oh, I got to do it exactly the way he does it, or I got to do it exactly the way this other guy does it, or you got to do it exactly the way I do it. But that's not the case, right? Actually, for me, it turns out being different each time because a lot of these conversations are organic, and sometimes it's more kind of testimony based, and sometimes you're giving more analogies or based on maybe the person's past experience with Christianity, you're answering questions or you're doing those things. But I just want to tell you, it's okay if it doesn't come out all clean and perfect, right? None of these conversations will ever be perfect. And you might come away feeling like, oh, I said the wrong thing, but that's okay, right? The fear and anxiety associated with that is okay, right? It just means that we care. We want it to be good. We want to please God in this. And God sees that. But he also says, look, hey, you go, right? Like I've called you to go. Don't let your insecurities or fears or the fact that you feel ill-equipped get in the way. Don't let your pride stop you from humbling yourself and just going out there and sharing, right? Because these people need to hear from you. Let your love for people quench your fear of them, right? And your fear of God and your love for God quench all that other fear of people, right? Because God is the one who we're serving in this. And so it's okay if it's messy. It's okay if it's you don't say everything right, right? I never do. But now you have some tools in your back pocket that you can use in sharing. And just go. You got it, okay? I hope you guys enjoyed this video and you got something from it. My goal on this channel is to help you follow Jesus daily. And the way I can continue to do that is because of people like you who are on Patreon supporting me on a monthly basis. Our goal is to get to 50 patrons this month. We are at 24 patrons. It is $5 a month to support me on there. And if you're passionate about the mission of helping people follow Jesus daily, if that's a mission you want to get behind, please sign up at patreon.com/daily_disciple, and that would be amazing. Help us get to our goal. That would be huge. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe down below if you want to watch more videos because like this. I'm putting out new videos all the time. Give it a like if you enjoyed this video, and I will see you next time. God bless.